Hello and welcome, everyone. This is Zachariah 1688 with another We Fail At. I do believe this is episode 9. As you can see, we are here along with the Kerbal Space Program. Alright, let's go to the Vehicle Assembly Building. This episode's primarily going to be me building an episode. This episode's going to be me building an episode. How exciting! No, this episode's going to be me building a ship. Possibly letting you in on a couple secrets. It depends on how drunk I get. There we go. As you can see there, first things I did, or I have done, because I'm doing this while I'm recording, is I lifted up the command module and placed a parachute on top. Safety first, here we fail at. There we go. Now we get a stack decoupler, so that way we can leave the rest of the ship behind just in case things go haywire, as they're prone to do. And what I have found easy to do is to grab an advanced SAS module and then two RCS canisters, because you run through those things a lot quicker than you think you would. Alright, our symmetry tool here is set to 4 already. That's good, because we're going to do that right there. And just provide just a little bit better mobility, I guess it would be a maneuverability. There you go, that's the word I was looking for, maneuverability. Where'd it go? There we go. We're gonna see that. We're going to set these down here and offset them. Alright, so with that offset, let's go here and get some atmospheric maneuverability. Grab a winglet set at 4. There we go. This is not going to be a spectacularly awesome vessel. This is just going to get us up there and get us down. This is... hopefully. Alright. Now, there's an advanced SAS module and a regular SAS module. The regular SAS module is a thruster enforcer, mainly. What you do normally with this is you will stack it on a... well, here, let me go ahead and show you. Do this. No, not the solid rocket. You're more trouble than you're worth, solid rocket booster. Get out of my face. Here we go. Stack a larger rocket to it there. Alright. Go here. And that should put 4 all the way on. Yes, it does. And here, apologies for the sniffly nose if you can pick it up. Just a bit of an allergy today. But what we're going to do is we're going to have 4 liquid rocket boosters to try to get us up and away. And what those regular SAS modules will do is they will actually boost torque and therefore thrust. They will boost the torque, meaning they will boost the oomph of the actual launching of the vessel. So that means we'll get up there just a tad bit quicker. At least that's what I have found. It could be just because I'm getting used to the scene. But we'll get up there just a tad bit quicker with that. And then we should be fine. Now, the command module here is partially a stability module, like this advanced SAS is. If you look to the right of the screen, it'll show a highlight. But this command module primarily acts as a balance between a regular SAS, which is a thruster, and a command an advanced SAS. So I guess it's like an advanced, it's a semi-advanced SAS? I don't know the best way to put it. It's just a command module. But it will actually help with control with this SAS, and it will help with the thrust with this engine and this engine, because they're in direct line with each other. So, technically, according to the wiring that we can't place, those are connected together. Alright. Now, with that done, this is pretty much going to be the base of it. You know, I think I am going to go ahead and add some solid rocket boosters. This is against my better judgment, but hey, gotta try every now and then. All right, put you here. Now, I did switch the symmetry tool off for this, just because I found that sometimes the symmetry tool is a little bit bugged. And when you say you want to play something in spot X, it won't play spot that in spot X perfectly in symmetrical fashion like you would like. It's a trial and error. Sometimes when I load up the game, the symmetry tool works perfect for me. I'm just like, yay, no worries, everything's okay. And other days I have to be doing this. So I guess it's kind of better that I have to do this for the video then. That way I get to show you. There we go. Alright, now we're going to be placing... Will this work? No. See what I mean? What that should do is place a solid rocket booster on every single one of the... What is that? That is a radial decoupler. Pardon my lack of vocabulary for the space program. I've only been doing this game for, what, 8-9 episodes now? Solid rocket boosters, while they're crazy and uncontrollable and don't have very, very solid backstory, so to speak, they do go very fast, very hard and fast, like a stripper. No, that's a bad pun. Excuse me, YouTube. But, alright. Enough of that. Enough of that dilly-dallying around. Now we are going to take these EAS-4 strut connectors. I've also found these to be a little bit bugged in this version, for the simple fact that whenever you save a craft and load it back up, if you've placed these anywhere, you have to give the ship a once-over, because sometimes they will disconnect themselves, and they will not be at all stable or a strut connector. But what they are supposed to do is to help with the stability of a vessel, so that way hopefully it doesn't shake as bad whenever you're on your way up. Now, they will disconnect as you... There we go. As you get higher and higher, and you want to disengage different stages, they will disengage with whatever stage you're dropping off and letting fall back to the atmosphere, or just float for eternity in the absence that is space. All right. All right, sorry about the brief pause there. Had to do some things real quick. But anyway, we're back, and I am going to go ahead and try to turn on the symmetry tool again for this. Hopefully it's not completely bugged. We're going to use two bug tools, and what we're going to do is to try to provide even more stability. We're going to do this here. Raise it up, and then connect here. Oh wow, that actually worked this time. Sometimes that doesn't work. That's a hit and miss with that. Alright. I do believe we already have a vessel called the We Fail At. So we will call this the We Fail... Oops, if I can type it right. Fail at typing. Version 2. We Fail At V2. I'm going to save that there. And then I'm going to cut here because I'm almost at the end of my time, and I'll be right back with some more of the minute details, and we're going to launch this puppy and see if it works.